Hello friends, today we will be studying the osteological features of the coccyx. Now, coccyx is formed by fusion of the four coccygeal vertebrae. Now, this is the bony pelvis and what we see here is the coccyx. Now, the word coccyx is derived from the Greek word kuku, which is name of a bird. This is due to the fact that the bone resembles the beak of a bird. It is also called as the tailbone because it is highly developed in animals having a tail. The coccyx is directed downwards and forwards. As I said, it is formed by fusion of four coccygeal vertebrae. It is triangular in shape, having a base directed upwards and an apex directed downwards, and it has two surfaces, a ventral surface facing anteriorly and a dorsal surface which faces posteriorly, and it has got two borders, two lateral borders, right lateral border and left lateral border. Now the base or the superior end of the coccyx is going to articulate with the apex or the lower end of the sacrum. And this base or superior border of coccyx is nothing but the body of the first coccygeal vertebra. The coccygeal cornua project from the posterolateral part of the base. Coccygeal and sacral cornua are connected to each other by intercorneal ligaments. The transverse process of the coccyx projects laterally from the base. When we talk of the apex, it is formed by the last coccygeal segment, and the apex gives attachment to the anococcygeal raphe on the ventral aspect. When we talk of the two surfaces, the pelvic surface or the anterior surface, it is related to the ganglion impar. It provides attachment to the ventral sacrococcygeal ligament on either side of the midline. And more laterally, it gives attachment to the coccygeus and levator ani muscles. When we talk of the dorsal surface of the coccyx, this surface provides attachment to the gluteus maximus muscle nearer to the lateral borders, the sphincter ani on the apex of the coccyx on this surface. On either side, nearer to the midline, this surface gives attachment to the dorsal sacrococcygeal ligament. And at the upper end, at the midline, it gives attachment to the phylum terminale. When we go on to see the two lateral borders, the right lateral and the left lateral borders, these give attachments to two ligaments, the sacrotuberous ligament and the sacrospinous ligament. Joints formed by the coccyx, its superior end forms a joint with the inferior end of the sacrum, that's the sacrococcygeal joint, and that is a secondary cartilaginous joint or a symphysis. Thus, we have seen the morphological features, attachments, and joints formed by the coccyx. Thank you.